Do you want to create a custom cursor without using frameworks? It's easier than you think. Hello, my friends. Welcome back. Thank you so much for coming to join me. In this video, we'll walk you through the steps needed to create a custom cursor for your website or application without relying on any external frameworks. We'll also provide some tips and tricks for making the process easier and faster. So, if you are ready to get started, let's dive in. Before getting into specific, you should be aware that some knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript is needed to understand the concept covered in this video. However, don't worry if you don't have any prior experience with the coding. This video is still beginner-friendly and will provide all the necessary steps for the creating a custom cursor. All you need to get started is a code editor and a browser. To begin, we will set up the HTML structure. This will involve two divs that we will use to create the cursor. The first div, which will be our cursor dot, to display the visual representation of the cursor, and second one, which we can call cursor outline div for the outer circle. Once the basic HTML structure is set up, we can move to the styling the cursor with CSS. The first step is to disable the default cursor. This is done by adding code cursor none to the body element. This will hide the normal cursor and allow you to create your own custom cursor. Next, two divs are created with the class names cursor dot and cursor outline. This will allow us to style them and give them a unique cursor look like. Now, add width height and background color to cursor dot, then width height and border to cursor outline. Okay, now make the cursor dot and cursor outline more stylish. They will remain at the center by fixing their position to top left 0 and translating by -50% for both directions. The border radius for circling should be 50%. Pointer events none and z-index 1 for making the cursor clickable. Finally, the JavaScript code is needed to make the cursor work. In order to make cursor move, we need to select each kind of cursor from the DOM using JavaScript query selector. Simply add a data attribute to each cursor to easily select them. Next, we need to add an event listener on the window to detect when mouse move, and use the client x and client y properties to keep track of the x and y position of the cursor while moving it. Then update the left and top position by adding style on the cursor dot. Now add same style to the cursor outline as well. Great, but it isn't complete yet. We still need to add smooth animation to the cursor outline to give it more life. For the animation, we are going to use the animate method, which takes two arguments. First, which properties do you want to animate? In this case, top and left. Second is the animation options like duration and fill mode, etc. Great, now we have a custom cursor. And we are really delighted to show you how to create a unique cursor that you can use on your museum or other websites or platforms where you'd like to display your work. Wait, I have something to tell you. I got uncountable requests to do voiceover in my videos. That's why I decided to do this for you guys. Thank you so much for inspiring me. If this is your first time watching my videos, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And of course, by supporting me on Patreon, you'll be helping me to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching. See you on the next video.